Welcome along to another Biggles video. Can you service your own car? Of course you can. What could possibly go wrong? Before we get started, let's take a look around this 2003 Mini Cooper S, completely original, with just over 100,000 miles on the clock. The bodies keep quite well on these. There's no rust coming through anywhere. The wheels could probably do with a little bit of a refurbish. But other than that, it's in very good condition. We take a look inside. The only signs of wear inside are the usual things on the seat here, where you get in and out. That could be repaired, but other than that, it's in quite good condition. A bit basic by today's standards, I guess. Radio cassette. Not bad. Bit of room in the back. There is a little bit of leg room. Let's have a look under the bonnet. There we are, quite a tidy engine bay. I've done a few odd jobs on this over the years, nothing too drastic. This is a common problem, the water bottle, the original ones, where that seam is, the original ones tend to leak. This one was replaced a few years ago and it's been perfectly right, but that seems to be a stock fault with a leak on the water bottle. Other things, the original air intakes here were a terrible design, horrible. I don't know what the material was. It only lasted a few minutes. And then these were replaced under warranty. They're complete plastic. The other one had some kind of foam inserts that were a shocking design. What else have I done to it over the years? Recently, a recent job was replace this engine mount here. If you notice, if you've got one of these and you notice there's a sort of brown fluid around here, it took me a little while to figure out what was going on, but these leak and leak the fluid, so that had to be replaced. That was quite an easy job, just dismantle all these bits and pieces. I think that's really about it under the engine bay. It's had the usual exhaust over the years. It has a stainless steel exhaust on at the moment. I say at the moment, I mean, that should last forever, shouldn't it? Well, here we are. It's a beautiful sunny morning, perfect for a service. What are we going to replace then? Spark plugs, all four spark plugs, air filter, oil filter, oil. And also, the last job we'll have a look at is replacing the brake fluid. Right, the car's up on ramps. Let's get started first and drain the oil. I use one of these old oil containers. Just cut the top out and then you can drain the oil into that. Here's the oil drain plug. We need a 13 millimeter socket on it. And by the way, I have already run the engine up to get the oil nice and warm so it comes out. We'll just get this catcher underneath it. Get ready for the oil spurt out a little bit. There we go. And the oil's just coming down as a little dribble. While that's still coming out, We'll go up to the top and try and remove the filter. Here's the oil filter then. This piece just here, and you can see there's a big nut on the top, which to undo that we'll need a 36 millimeter socket. Right, there's the socket on. This is removing the oil filter housing. I think by now we can undo it by hand. Right, there it is. Here, there it is, complete with the filter. So here's the filter in the housing. I'll just pull that out. There's quite a bit of oil left in that housing. I'm going to just put the filter there so we know which way around it goes. Also, another little job to do is there's a sealing, rubber sealing ring around there. That needs to come off. We'll clean all this up, put the new filter in. It's a messy job. Don't do this if you're worried about getting your hands dirty. Now, one thing to note here is if you've got a fancy driveway, you might want to put another bowl underneath the filter, because when you take the filter off, you get a bit of oil. I'm not worried here because that will all blast off with the pressure washer later. Right, so we have the filter bowl here. Let's clean this up, put the new rubber ring on it and a new filter, and we'll be ready to pop that back on. Right, first up then is to get the old rubber ring off. Just prise that off with a screwdriver. Then we want to clean this up, petrol works well, there we are, that's come up quite nicely. Just put a little bit around the outside just to clean that up. It's nice to put things back in nice clean condition. There we are. Lovely. All done. Right, so with the kit, the new one, the new filter, comes a new O-ring, which we'll just pop on there. And that seals the oil. There we are, that's on. Here's the filter, which we'll just take a look and compare. So that's the way the original one was, that way around. So assuming that that's correct, you just press that in there. That will stay in there now. Right, the one last thing that needs to be done is just get a little bit of oil on my finger and just run it round that rubber, just to lubricate it. There we are. We're all ready to put back on now. So here's the filter, ready to go back. And it should stay in there. Yes, it does. So we'll pop that down there. And just going to tighten it up by hand to start with. The socket on it now. Once it gets up to that rubber O-ring, it starts to get a little bit tight. You need to use the socket on it. to tighten it up. That's why we put a little bit of oil on that O-ring, so it would slip in easier. We get in there, should be able to feel the gap. I don't know why, but they always put these oil filters in a difficult place to get to, and yet it's the thing that you need to get to on a regular basis. Why couldn't they stick it at the front somewhere? Eh? Right, so that's just got tight. I'm just going to tighten that up. Alright. Well, there's still a little bit of oil dribbling out of the bottom, so while we're waiting for that, we'll replace the spark plugs, and for that we'll need a 10 millimeter long reach plug socket. Here are the plugs. Don't get these muddled up. I don't think you can, actually, because of the lead length, but we won't take any chances. We'll put the plug caps in order. Right, okay, so we've got our long reach plug spanner. Okay, so here's our first plug out. I've discovered that to get the other plugs out, the socket fouls a little bit on this edge, so I'm going to take this plastic piece off because we want to get a nice firm wrench on the plugs. Well, there we are, all the plugs are out now, so we'll start assembling with the new plugs. This socket does hold them in. There's a piece of rubber in the top that just grips into them. Be careful putting them in that you don't cross thread them or anything.
First, and then I'll go around tightening them up.
Right, they're all in. Now we'll go round and just give them a little tighten. Not over tighten them, because it's an alloy head. We have to be a bit careful. Don't worry if the socket comes off when you're pulling this back out. If you just lean over a bit with your socket, you can drag it out, because sometimes this will pop off and the socket will be left down there. Don't panic, just lean it over a bit and then you can drag it out. So there we are, plugs are in. All we need to do now is just pop these back in. You can see I've done it in the wrong order, haven't I? That needs to go in first. That one. That one. that one, and that one. There we are. Plugs all done. While this top's off, we'll just give this a quick wipe over. It looks a bit greasy up this end. Smarten it up a little bit. Goes on there. Two long bolts at that end. I put a little bit of oil on the threads. And then just tighten this back up. There we are. That's that job done. Next job up then is to replace the air cleaner. That's located under there. So we'll just remove that top. We've got a couple of screws here at this end. I think they're actually the sort of screws that stay on the top. Then this piece here just lifts off. That's has some the power. You can just lift that out of the way. Should be able to get past that. Then this little clip has to come off, really, to get this top off. So let's get that clip off next. Right, this pipe needs to come off, and it's held on by one of these strange clamps. I think you can get a tool to remove this clamp, but I haven't got one, so we'll just have to prise it off. There we are. Give that filter box a little bit of a wipe round while we're at it. It's not too bad actually. Right, so the new filter then. Just sits in that box there. Like that. There we are, there's the new filter. So the box then just, there's only the two screws. The back end just clips over some little lugs, but what we've got is this electricity thingy there, which is in the way. is nearly there. That's it. Right. Now, just to put those screws back in. Lost my screwdriver. Oh, where's that gone then? Ah, there it is, right in front of me. Okay, we'll just tighten those screws up. That electrical thing just clips on the side there. Pipe presses back on. Should do. Okay, it's got a little bit jammed up. There it goes, it's on. Now the only thing we've got left to do now is to get that clip back on over there. There we are. Well, I managed to get that back over with a bit of jiggery pokery. That's in place. Pipe's back on. Everything's done. That's that job done. Over tighten it. There we are. Don't over tighten it, but don't leave it too loose either. Here's the old oil. It's not going down the drain, by the way. It'll be used to paint a fence post to preserve it before I fit it. So that's going to be put to good use. One last job. Refill the engine with some oil. 5W30, apparently it's recommended for this car with this sort of mileage, so let's top it up. It'll take most of this oil. Job done. So next up then is to bleed the brakes. What we need to do is take this little cap off here and then put a pipe on there. We'll just loosen it a bit first though with a socket. Alright, that's a little bit loose. We'll pop a pipe on there, get a spanner on and start bleeding the brakes. So this is where the brake fluid is stored. What we need to do is to regularly top this up as we go along. Right, well what we've got now is that pipe is on the brake bleed screw. I've loosened the screw and the jar will fill up with the brake fluid. I've got my assistant on the brake pedal. Can you press it twice and hold it down? I see we're pumping the fluid through. What we have to do is keep topping this up and pump it till this fluid comes through nice and clean. Give it two more pumps and hold it down. Here we go with some more. Two more presses. Hold it down. We'll just top this up before it goes too low. You can see at the back here now that the fluid's starting to come through clean on the pipe. So we'll just give it a couple more presses. Two more presses. now it looks quite clean. There's no air in it, so what we're going to do now is just tighten up the nut. Alright, that's tightened it, so no more will come here. We'll just leave this for a minute, and we're going to now go over the other side. We're at the back of the car, by the way. I should have said that. You have to start at the back. This is now set up on the other side, so we're going to do the same again. Lead the brakes through. Okay, couple of presses. Two more. It's coming through quite clear. I've just got to pop round to the front again, top it up. See, it's filling the jar up nicely, and the pipe looks quite clear. I think we'll call that done on this side. We've just got to tighten that nut up. We'll tighten the other nut up, put the dust covers back on. There's some rubber dust covers that go on, and then we'll go round to the front of the car. Here we are at the front now. And there's the bleed screw, so we'll fit a pipe on that one to start on the front here. Right, so here we are on the other side, and we've got a little bit of air in the pipe by the look of it there. Just give it two more pumps. Right, and hold it down. Right, that's gone now. Do is we'll just top it up a little bit more here. Have to keep this topped up, by the way. If you let this go down, then you have to start all over again because the air will get in. So we'll just top that up. There we are. Right, two more pumps and hold it down. Well, there we are, the car's all serviced, brake fluid replaced. That's what new brake fluid looks like, and that is what the old stuff looks like. That's the difference. So what did it cost to service the Mini? Well, it was £84 altogether, and that's for the spark plugs, oil filter, air filter, oil, and also brake fluid. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.